The goal of this video is to show how to connect M580 CPU to an HMI, including a secondary connection. A few steps are required to connect a M580 PLC to an HMI, including a secondary connection. We will configure first the PLC project. Then, we will configure the Modbus TCP driver into the HMI application. Then, we will connect the PLC to the HMI. Finally, we will see the management of the communication between the primary connection and the secondary connection. Here is the topology used in this video. The HMI can be connected through the CPU module or the NOC module. In this example, we will connect the Video Web Gate to check the behavior of the HMI. Here is the EchoStruxure Control Expert application. There are two Ethernet modules allowing to connect an HMI. The first module is the CPU. The second one is the NOC. To configure the IP address of the CPU, double-click on the Ethernet ports of the module. Make sure that port 502 is activated for Modbus communication. Repeat the same steps to configure the Ethernet ports for the NOC module. In this example, we are using unlocated variables. For this reason, the data dictionary feature is activated. To configure the HMI part, we will have two possibilities. The first possibility consists of using the secondary connection as native feature. Now let's switch to Video Designer to configure the HMI application using the native feature. The first equipment is using secondary connection as native feature. Double-click on the equipment to configure the IP addresses. As you can see, CPU IP address is configured as primary connection. NOC module IP address is the secondary connection. Keep data dictionary activated as we are using unlocated variables from the PLC. In this example, I added the system variables dedicated to manage the secondary connection feature. You can find more information about these variables into the online help. Let's switch back to EchoStruxure Control Expert to download and run the PLC application. Now switch to Video Designer to download the HMI application. I can connect to the HMI using the web gate. You can see that the variables are exchanged properly between the PLC and the HMI through the CPU. If the communication is lost with the CPU, the HMI connects to the NOC to keep the communication with the PLC. The HMI remains connected to the NOC even if the communication with the CPU is restored. The communication switches back to the CPU when an issue occurs with the NOC. Now let's see the second possibility to use a secondary connection. In this method, we will use some scripts to check a communication error and then change the equipment IP address. As you can see, this equipment is not using a secondary connection as native feature. Only the CPU IP address is configured. Here are the different actions used to manage the secondary connection. In this specific action, we are using equipment method functions to change the IP address of the equipment. There is an example in the online help to show how to configure an equipment IP address by using a script. Now let's switch to the HMI to see how it works. You can see that the variables are exchanged properly between the PLC and the HMI through the CPU. I added a switch to activate the secondary connection function. You can configure a secondary connection from here. This is the current IP address used to connect to the PLC. Each time there is a communication error on one module, we will automatically switch to the other module.